Welcome to Tech to Tech presented by Kaizen, where we will explore common cleaning questions and answers. This session has been pre-recorded and will include additional FAQs related to this specific topic at the end of the presentation. We hope it is 15 minutes well spent. Let's get started. I would like to introduce Kaizen's own, Octavio Paredes.
Thank you, William. Welcome, everyone. Thanks for attending to this short video. We are in the maintenance series. The topic is wave solder best practice for long-term success. Basically, we're going to see the maintenance and the importance of the maintenance in the wave solder. Unfortunately, we don't pay too much attention to the maintenance. I say this because most of the companies doesn't give neither the time nor the proper tools to perform a correct maintenance. I know that no company want to stop the production. On the contrary, they want to increase the production to generate more money. But you must be aware that lack of maintenance or an improper maintenance results in failures during the process and also damaging the equipments. As a result, non-production and loss of money. This is a typical wave solder configuration. We must be aware that all the sections form part of a complete system. If one of the sections is not in good conditions, we're going to have problems in the whole system. The first section is the fluxer. There are some causes and consequences that we need to focus. The clogged nozzles, badly oriented nozzles, bad O-rings, dirty filters, incorrect dispense, and dirty hose are some conditions that will result in spills in areas, chain contamination, damaged hoses, electrical damage, contamination due to excess flux, or lack of flux. And here we have some examples. The first thing is a clogged nozzle. We don't want to have clogged nozzles. Why? Because if something is blocking the nozzle, we're going to have some problems with the flux dispensed. We want to have all the PCB cover, and if something is clogging it, we cannot cover completely. The other thing is the orientation. At the moment that you do your maintenance to the nozzle and put it on the fluxer, you need to take care of the orientation. Why? Because the flux tries to cover all the PCB, but if the orientation is not the correct, probably you won't cover it correctly. Another thing is the O-rings. You must check that that your O-ring is in good conditions. Why? Because if not in good conditions, probably you're going to have some leaks, loss some pressures, and problems with the flux dispenser. Another thing to check here is the range of movement of the fluxer. If the fluxer have a wide range of movement, you are going to cover for sure the PCB. But what happened with the chains? You don't want to have flux in the chains. This will cause you problems in the future. Another thing is the hoses. You want to keep the hoses clean and do not bend. Being bent can affect the application of flux. About the filters and dosification, it's normal that after a while, the filter starts to accumulate flux. But what happens if you don't clean the filter? The flux starts to saturate the filter and starts to leak. What happened here? If the PCB goes through through this section, probably can some drops of flux start to cover the surface of the PCB. You don't want to have flux in this area. In the other picture, we have four examples of different dosifications. We need to take care of the calibration. Why? You don't want to have gaps between the flux layers, neither have overlap layers. Why not? Because if you have gaps between the layer, some parts of the PCB won't be completely covered. And if you have overlaps, you are going to have excess of flux that in the other section probably can start to drip and contaminate. So we have some recommended actions, and we recommend performing these actions periodically. Filter cleaning, dispense calibration, correct application of flux, correct orientation of nozzles, and hose cleaning. In the preheaters, depending on the brand of equipment is the technology that we can find. Blowers, infrared, cold rod, all of these are different examples of the Preheaters technology. It doesn't matter which one you have, applies the same for all of them. Once again, causes and consequences, dirty rails, dirty blowers, dirty thermocouples, clogged via holes, all these conditions will result in temperatures variability, chain jams, stressed engines, mechanical traction damage, vibration, non-stable process profile, and poor intermetallic bonding. We have two examples here. It's normal that the flux start to accumulate in the preheater section, in the case of the right picture. If the flux start to accumulate in the via holes, eventually it's going to clog it partially or completely. If we have clogged via holes, we're going to have variability of temperature. Some of them were going to in the desired temperature, and another ones no. It's the same for in the case of the cold road on the infrared. If the flux start to accumulate, it's going to form a layer in some parts of the cold road. So we're going to have variability in the temperature. In some areas, we're going to have the desired temperature, in another ones no. What happened with this? We're going to have problems with the flux activation. We need to have some specific temperatures in order to activate correctly the flux. So that's why we want to have these areas clean. In the case of the blowers, it's pretty much the same. If we start to have a clogged surface here, we're not going to have the hot air and start to have also variability in the temperature. In the case of the rails and the thermocouples, it's extremely important to have a clean reel. If the reel is not clean, it can generate a stuck, that the chain is stuck. And if we have this, probably we're going to have mechanical damage. In the case of the thermocouple, it's pretty much the same. If there is a layer of flux in the thermocouple, we're going to have a kind of delay between the reading that the thermocouple is getting and the reel temperature. And this is going to origin in a lot of variability in the temperatures and give us some problems in the future. Recommended actions: cleaning of blowers. That's how we want to look. They also cleaning infrared and preheatings, the via holes, and the thermocouple cleaning. Of course, the rail cleaning. There are other factors: the chains and fingers. Causes and consequences. Dirty chains, damaged fingers, welding on the fingers, little or not lubrication in the chains will result in chain binding, variability in the position of the PCBs, damaged tractions, equipment wear, shortcomings, shorts, poor intermetallic bonding. In this picture, not only the chain is dirty, all the system is dirty. What happened with we have a system like this? We're going to generate wear in all the system, and this can cause them to break or damage in the short or medium term. If we have dirty chains, we can force it. And what happens if the chain force it? The chain can get stuck or start to jump. What's the problem with this? In the case of the wave solder, if the PCB is passing to the wave solder and the chain starts to jump or get stuck, we're going to have more or less exposure, and this can result in short or shortcomings. Now, and the fingers. We don't want to have any kind of residue on the finger surface. Why not? Because if we try to sit the PCB on the finger and there is some kind of residue in the finger, we're going to have a inclination in the PCB. And when the PCB passes through the wave solder, probably some of the sides of the PCB won't be touched there correctly in the solder. That's why we don't want this. We have here two videos, the dirty chain versus a clean chain. It doesn't matter the speed of your process. We want a smooth movement. In the left one, we don't have it. We want like in the right one. You must be take care of this. The recommended actions, the chain cleaning, finger cleaning, chain lubrication, and the mechanical traction maintenance, the bearings, motor shaft, and sprockets. There are two more recommendations: the correct lubrication of the chain and fingers. Remember that when you wash a chain, you are not only removing all the residues, you are also removing the protection. So it's really important that after you clean your chain, protect your chain with some kind of lubricant or oil, protecting from the rust, and also that helps to keep the mobility of the chain. Another point: use a suitable lubricant. This is very important because you must take care that the greases or the oil that you're going to use for the process is the correct one. What happens if you don't use the correct one? Like in this example, probably this grease at the moment that passed through all the wave solder machine, the grease becomes sticky and give you more problems. Very careful. We don't recommend the use of alcohol for any maintenance process. Why? Due to the characteristics of the alcohol. It's highly risky, highly flammable. Why do you use the alcohol? Because it's cheap. But is it really cheap? We're going to see. When you are choosing between alcohol and a cleaning agent, there are some points that you have to consider before doing your choice. The first one is the safety. We have seen before that the alcohol is not safety. Instead, the cleaning agents are designed for this specific process. So all these, or the majority of the cleaning agents, will be safer for your process. What about the effectivity? Probably the alcohol can remove completely the residues, but how many times do you need to do it, and how many efforts do you need it? Once again, the cleaning agent is designed for this specific purpose. So it, for sure, it's going to take less time and less effort, and also less amount of the cleaning agent. Finally, the cost benefit. The alcohol is cheap, but once again, how many effort you need to remove, how many persons you need to involve to the maintenance process. Instead of the cleaning agent, for sure, you are going to need a less cleaning agent, less effort, and less time. At the end, probably will be pretty much the same. But you must remember that the money is important, but your safety is its first. In conclusion, we have seen during all the presentation that the equipment maintenance is a fundamental part of the success of your daily operation. Not doing maintenance or incorrect maintenance will bring the following consequences: scrap, damaged equipment, downtimes, spare parts, unproduced parts, and unsold parts. I assume we can say that you can lose money. Now, the frequently asked question: what is the cleaning time of a chain? All depends of how dirty is your chain. Also depends the equipment that you have, if you're going to do it with manually. If you can't with the, if you doesn't count with the equipment and you need to do it manually, probably a couple of days. If you have a washer machine and a cleaning agent, probably since 1 to 4 hours. And once that you start to clean in a regular basis, will take less time. Next question: how often should maintenance be done? Once again, all depends on your process and how dirty it is. Depends also how many hours you have been running. I recommend you to go all through this presentation and start to register and see your specific process. And with that, this will give you at your specific time for you. If a wave solder that was working correctly begins to show variability, what do you recommend to doing? If it was working properly and now you see variability, that means that something has changed. Before to move any parameters, temperatures, etc., I recommend you to go through all these points that we have done and start to apply them. If after that you see that the variability remains, then it's time to do some change in the parameters. That concludes my presentation. I'll pass it to William.
Thanks, Octavio. Thank you all for watching this tech-to-tech session. If you would like to discuss this topic further or have any questions not answered in the session, please contact your local Kaizen regional manager or send an email to tech2tech kaizen@kaizen.com, and we will have someone follow up with you as soon as possible. Do you want to have exclusive access to future content sent directly to your inbox, or do you know someone who would benefit from these sessions? If the answer is yes, just go to tech2techbykaizen.com to fill out the subscription form. And if you like this video, be sure to follow us on our social media platforms for more expert cleaning content.